back, I always remember hearing jokes about how small our graduating classes were. Everyone had fun with the jokes. We took pride in our community and our collective accomplishments, despite our size. Tragically, however, our class reunions are smaller than our graduating classes and getting smaller. Why is that? We keep losing more and more of our classmates to drug overdoses, and as we all know, this is an exclusive northern group. When I ran for mayor three years ago, I honestly wasn't expecting to be dealing a whole lot with drug use. When I eventually talked to residents, we discussed things like economic development, taxes, communication, and our village's core services like water, sewer, streets, and sidewalks. Now everything has changed. Now the topic on the minds of many of our residents is addiction. Even in small, outlying rural communities like ours, we're seeing people struggle, families destroyed, lives lost. While I know too many horror stories to count, a few come to mind. I can tell you about losing four lives to overdose in the northern room in the span of 10 days last summer. I can tell you about the time someone stopped me on the street to tell me that they had just bought wrapping paper at Dollar General to take it to their car and find out the heroin was stashed beside it. I can tell you about the time a passionate young woman attended one of our addiction awareness events at Whitney Point and spoke to us about the need for more treatment options, only to die of an overdose shortly thereafter. I can tell you that in the last month alone, we've lost three more lives in rapid succession right in Northern Broom. These deaths are shocking to us all everywhere, but small towns where everyone seems to know each other and recognize family names going back generations, it seems even more surprising and heartbreaking every time there's another obituary in the paper. We find ourselves asking who's next. I quickly realized that many of the things that we work on in government don't matter as much when our residents aren't living constructive lives, raising their children, working for a living, or worse, are dying. All the economic development, responsible budgeting in the world means less when lives are being lost, both figuratively and literally at such rapid rates. Based on my experiences as both a 2005 Whitney Point graduate and mayor of a Southern Tier community, the need for a proposed treatment facility couldn't be more clear. The most common argument that I hear pertaining to the approval of the new facility revolves around money. I hear people question whether or not we have the money to spend on a facility like this. Some take it a step further and question whether or not we should spend money to help people struggling with substance use at all. All moral arguments aside, people need to understand that taxpayer money is already being used to combat addiction. Law enforcement is working around the clock to try to shut down drug dealers and combat property crime like break-ins, thefts, and robberies that are associated with drug use. Emergency personnel are constantly responding to calls for drug overdoses. Children are being put in foster care when their addicted parents can no longer care for them. The court system is dedicating huge amounts of time and money to hearing, prosecuting, and defending drug cases. Medicaid is being utilized to pay for the treatment of health issues caused by drug use. The coroner's office is blowing their budget because of the increase in unexpected deaths, especially amongst young people. Many people are unemployed and receive public assistance because their addiction got in the way of their ability to work. And we're putting addicted people in jail, paying to house them and care for them for the duration of the sentence, only to see them get back out to the world, use the drugs again, get arrested again, go through court again, and get put in jail again. All of this costs money. Many of us here have probably heard the phrase, treating the symptom and not the disease. That is exactly how we're handling addiction. We're spending unprecedented amounts of money trying to deal with the problem, but we're not spending hardly anything trying to solve it. If we want to be fiscally responsible, we need to plan and invest in long-term solutions. It'll be more cost-effective to treat those suffering with substance use and give them the tools that they need to overcome their addiction than it is to continue doing what we're doing now, which is clearly perpetual and ineffective. This facility is not a silver bullet. We know that. Many people have questions about the details of the proposal. We get that. Money is tight. We all get that. In government, we have to be careful with every dime we spend and review every detail. But we cannot claim that we're being fiscally responsible with taxpayer money and continue dealing with addiction the way that we are now. We have to evolve our methods and we have to invest in order to save lives. If we can't find enough compassion in our hearts to care for each other and approve this facility, then approve it in the long-term best interest of the public's wallets. Thank you.